Hi there, it's Rachel Smalley.
And Toba O'Brien.
We both want to welcome you to Today FM.
I'm really proud to be the Foundation Breakfast host on this station, along with Mark and Carly.
A station that believes in fairness, accountability and truth.
And a station that wants to help understand all perspectives and not jump to conclusions. We won't get it right all the time, but we can't get it wrong if we do it together. So hi to Mai, welcome to the all-new Today FM.
Morena, New Zealand, Duncan Garner here. I'm so looking forward to joining you after 9 o'clock this morning to talk about the questions of the day, try to come up with some of the answers, but mostly to hear your stories, what's happening in your today. This is the gig I think I was always meant to do, and I can't wait.
It's been a hot summer.
Oh, it's our turn. Leah Parnipa.
And Mark Richardson here.
We host the afternoon show. There's a lot I'm looking forward to, but mostly it's working with me mate Mark again. It should be a lot of fun.
Well, I'm glad to hear you're looking forward to working with me again.
Kia ora, it's Bryn Rudkin here on air with Danny Watson. We can't wait to get on air and build the Today FM community overnight. Just remember, Today FM is here 24/7.
Lloyd Burr here.
And Wilhelmina Shrimpton.
We're with you at the tail end of your workday for Lloyd Burr Live.
The latest news, interviews and what you've missed while you've been at work.
On the all-new Today FM.
Hi, it's Polly. And you've got me each night. We're going to share real stories and real life challenges. And because I know through the Today FM community, we can help each other through this thing called life.
We are standing by for transmission of New Zealand's new talk station. Today FM. Firstly, here's Dame Heniwehi Mohi with the New Zealand National Anthem.
E hoa atua o ngā iwi mātora a ta whakarongona me aroha. Whai mana kitia mai Aotearoa. God of nations at thy feet, in the bonds of love we meet. Hear our voices we entreat. God defend our free land. God Pacific's triple star, from the shafts of strife and war, make her praises heard afar. God defend New Zealand.
Today FM, beginning transmission in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's been a brutal couple of years. A worldwide pandemic.
New Zealand will go into lockdown.
Global uncertainty.
Bashing Hillary Clinton, the media.
The country literally divided.
Jacinda Ardern announced a 3-day lockdown in the country's biggest city, Auckland.
A clash of beliefs.
I'm not vaccinated. It's not going to make any difference.
Whānau split on what's right and what's not.
The only reason they live is because of vaccinations.
Politics and science merging into a confusing muddle.
We need everyone in every corner of New Zealand to be protected.
It's natural to wonder, how is was this all going to end? After great challenge always comes great opportunity. This is our moment to reflect, to think and regroup, to refocus on what really matters, on family and friends, our health and relationships. A time to rebuild businesses and rekindle connections. We are so ready to come out of our houses with new thinking that makes the most of a new world. Carrying through the good stuff, what we stand for, what we believe, but with a sense of optimism and positivity. Because while there are a lot of questions that will need to be answered, we don't have to work it out alone. So New Zealand, what's next? Welcome to Today FM. News that moves us forward.
Morning, I'm Carly Flynn at 5. Ukraine's president is pleading with his Russian counterpart for negotiations. It comes as a school-turned bomb shelter housing hundreds of people.
First Light, your early morning briefing.
In the besieged city of Mariupol, Volodymyr Zelensky told CNN he will do anything to stop the war.
We're losing people on a daily basis, innocent people on the ground. Russian forces have come to exterminate us, to kill us.
Calls are growing for the government to create a pandemic toolkit. Cabinet will meet to discuss vaccine mandates and the traffic light system today. Epidemiologist Professor Michael Baker says the virus is not going away anytime soon, so some measures are needed.
We have this phrase, the let it rip approach, and Freedom Day, which is what we saw in the UK. You find that the pandemic has other ideas it takes off, and then you have to reimpose some of those rules.
Meanwhile, there are fears about an uptick of cases in the wake of St. Patrick's Day. Thousands of students flocked to the streets of Dunedin, some throwing parties with more than 100 people. Infectious diseases physician Professor Kirk Kraus says most cases will not have shown up yet.
The incubation period's in that 3 to 5 day range for most people with Omicron, so we might start seeing something about 5 days or so after the 17th.
New details have emerged following the shooting of a man by police in Invercargill. The man presented a knife to officers when stopped on State Highway 1 yesterday, and police allege he also rimmed a patrol car, confronted motorists and broke into vehicles prior to being shot. A wet and overcast day for people in the north. Severe thunderstorm warnings are in place across the country, including in Auckland and the Coromandel. Fire and emergency are receiving multiple calls of flooding in Moriwa in the far north. In sport, Chiefs Manawa have claimed the inaugural Super Rugby Opiki title. They've beaten the Blues to end the three-round tournament unbeaten. In the other game yesterday, Hurricanes Power beat Matatu 18-6. Wins to the Knights and the Broncos to close out round two of the NRL. The Knights beat the Tigers 26-4, while the Broncos beat the Bulldogs 16-10. NRL with Machinery House in a league of their own. And the Breakers have gone down in their latest Aussie NBL basketball game. They've been beaten 95-85 by Perth. Centre Yanni Wetzel top scored with 15 points. The Breakers' season record is 5 wins and 15 losses.
On 90.2 Auckland, this is Today FM News.
First Light, your early morning briefing.
With Rachel Smalley.
On Today FM.
Morena, good morning, New Zealand. Today is going to be a great day. I'm Rachel Smalley with you through to 6:30. Welcome to your Monday. It's the 21st of March.
First Look
on First Light.
Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky says he's ready for negotiations.